I'd like to introduce, first of all, our executive director, and I have to say, the visionary, who when he first saw this building walked out, and when I asked him, I said, what do you want to do with this building, told me it's going to be a home for homeless high school kids. This is an opportunity to fulfill dreams in a way that was not possible ever, ever before. So we're really appreciative of this opportunity, and thank you for all your support.
I was a homeless kid when I was growing up too, and so because I was homeless, not only did I have something, but I didn't have a place. I didn't go to school either. I didn't have someone that was going to help encourage me along the way to get that done. Even getting your homework done. If you don't have a mom or a dad or someone speaking into that, there's not a great chance you're going to see that succeed. Well, the other cool thing about this project, I love to see that it isn't just one community member or one agency trying to get it done. It's really the community looking at the needs in the community, and we all circle hands together and achieve this.
We formed the Council Committee on Homelessness and Youth to explore why there were so many homeless kids downtown. That was back in 1995. And what we discovered, obviously, was that these kids didn't have a place to go. They could not go home in many cases. This significantly laid the groundwork for a greater understanding in the community of how many kids need help that they're not getting at home. And that's what we're all about here today. It's all partnership, it's all teamwork.
But what I have always said about homelessness is we may not solve it for everyone, but we will solve it for the people we serve. And so we start here, and we start with this incredible opportunity. And I just want to say, because I'm a former development director, that I cannot stand in front of a group of people and not suggest that you pull out your pocketbooks. And if St. Mary's can build this project without borrowing, it then positions them to replicate this kind of project in other communities in Bethel, Springfield, and elsewhere. So keep that in mind. This isn't, you're investing not only in the youth who are here, you're investing in this model, and it will reverberate. So
I was part of the Springfield Community Development Corporation, and one of the buildings that we bought was a church. And so I absolutely see the advantage of buying buildings, because many times churches are well taken care of. And they have tons of rooms and space and kitchens and all sorts of things that absolutely make them perfect to do this kind of a project. So I'm very
what we have learned about youth and homeless youth is that if a youth spends more than 14 consecutive nights on the street, there's a significant chance that they will become chronically homeless. And so this is a very exciting project. Part of what we do know is that as they stay connected to schools, that's huge for them. There's some structure, there's some social structure for those youth to continue.
When Paul called and said, hey, we want to use this space for this idea, it was really easy for us to say, Yeah, we want the story that started back in the 50s of the people in place that have kind of saturated these walls, and we believe that there's something mysterious about the way those things come together. I don't know what you think about that. That may weird you out, but we think there's something here. And we want that story to continue, and we're extremely excited about that story continuing in terms of serving homeless youth.
The one thing that I also notice is that the community, the neighborhoods here, who invited the project in, and that is amazing as well. They said, how about here? Why not here? And you don't always get that response when you're working with at-risk populations. And I just am so thankful that this is a game changer. This will change the trajectory of the lives of students. I get very emotional when thinking about our at-risk populations, but this will be a game changer. It will change the trajectory of the lives of the students who come through this. This model is something that can definitely be replicated. In fact, I think I've already mentioned a couple of churches for sale in the Bethel area, so we might want to look at that.
If you can imagine, just vision this, loaded down with suitcases. They have, you know, all of their bedding in one, and all of their clothes, and everything, and maybe a backpack with a book or two in it. How are they going to concentrate on their schoolwork when they're worried about all this baggage that they're having to carry around? You know, and you're giving them that place. You're giving them a place to put that down so that they can go and they can concentrate on their education so that they can change the cycle and become citizens.
Years ago, a former counselor from Eugene by the name of Bobby Lee. He was a very young city councilor. And he was so challenged by what are we going to do with the young people who can no longer live in their home for whatever reason, and find out where they go and how they're dealing with it. He spent a week under the bridge with those people for an entire week and came back and talked to us about the significance of helping young people when they're in this key transitional period of their life.
When we said we're looking for churches and faith institutions to sponsor a kid, $6,000 a year, somebody raised their hand and said, is there a limit on how many kids we can sponsor? So First Congregational was the first church to step forward.
We now make a serious appeal to the 200 faith communities in Lane County that serve tens of thousands of people. Because the ideal of compassion, serving the needs of the most vulnerable among us, is part of every great religion in the world. So the reality is now that this youth house will need approximately $6,000 to support each homeless teenage student for 1 year.
I had called Vic, our chair, and we had discussed it with the board, and we all thought this was an incredible idea. We had talked to Heather with Southeast, and she immediately came over, as did Morgan with Friendly, the chair there. And we all were just looking at the place and saying, my God, you know, how many people can we put in here? And yeah, I must say, we did want more people, but that's their plan.
I've never seen a project that provides for homeless get a unanimously embrace, be embraced by a community. I've never seen that, and that's magical. That's happened here in this community. Not one person has said, we are going to stop you, we don't want this. When's the last time you have ever seen that in any community?
I started out on the housing board because I wanted to do something as I moved towards retirement in the community, and it's only opened up more and more wonderful vistas of people working together for the common wealth, the common good, which is what we all really want in this country and in these hard times. It's always a joy to have anything to do with St. Vinny's because it reminds me of all the good there is and how we can move forward.
By the way, the state is watching us very closely. Tina Kotek, Speaker of the House, we've met with her. They're watching this. They want to see how this happens. They want this to happen elsewhere across the state. So we have a lot to show people with this project. I didn't know whether I was going to share this, but I will. Ruth Dimler, a board member, had organized a bunch of tours. And I was on, I think, maybe 18th or 19th tour the other day, and I was giving this talk that I give. It's 20 minutes. I've got like six different versions, you know, that I feel like a jukebox, A2 or B3. You know, that I queue up. And I was doing this, and I always try to give it my best because I care so much about this project. And I was getting tired, and I was getting worn out. And I swear, this, people who think I'm crazy, this will confirm it. I saw the shapes of the girls coming down those stairs. And you know what I realized today is this is real. This is actually happening. As early as December, when this project's done, there's going to be young women who will have an option other than being on the street, from being sexually abused, from being trafficked, but an option to pursue a rich, full life. We'll be able to come in and have this extraordinary opportunity.
But I took notes on what everybody shared. And so you wrote the lyrics. And if we have a ground shaking, I'm going to invite anyone who's comfortable, and even if you're not a little bit, you know, we're talking about putting the energy in this room. Let's put the energy in this room. We celebrate together. Let's celebrate with a little music. So whoever's comfortable, come and get an instrument. Come stand up with me. This is the end. This is our song that we just wrote.
We're all in this town. We're gonna get It's a game changer. No one's a stranger.